मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू योर इंग्लिश क्लास। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे ऑफ कोर्स वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर ऑफ ग्रामर, बट बिफोर आई अनाउंस द टॉपिक आई वॉन्ट यू टू गेस द टॉपिक। लेट मी स्पीक अ फ्यू लाइन्स। मिस्टर शर्मा इज आवर इंग्लिश टीचर। Mr. Sharma is 40 years old. Mr. Sharma has the teaching experience of 15 years. Mr. Sharma is a kind-hearted personality. Now, I will be speaking the same sentences but in a slight different way. Mr. Sharma is our English teacher. He is 40 years old. He has the teaching experience of 15 years. He is a kind-hearted personality. I have spoken similar sentences in two phases. What is the difference then? Why I spoke these sentences in two phases? They were same. No, students, those were not same. In first phase, I spoke Mr. Sharma again and again. In each sentence I used noun, but in second phase bache I used he instead of Mr. Sharma again and again. I have replaced noun with a. Now at least guess the topic. Yes, I have replaced Mr. Sharma, which is a noun, with he, that is pronoun. And the same is our today's topic. So we are going to discuss pronouns today. We will be learning the definition, usage and kinds of pronoun. Now let's discuss in detail. Please focus on the text.
Topic: the pronoun. A pronoun is a word used in place of a noun that is used earlier. For example, Neeraj is a boy. He is my friend. Neeraj is already mentioned and he has been used at the place of Neeraj. So obviously he is pronoun. We use he instead of Neeraj or the boy. A pronoun can function as a subject, object and complement in a sentence. He is my friend. Obviously, he is in the subjective part. He is the doer of the action. So, hence it is called a subject. I met him yesterday. Him is object. This pen is mine. That is a compliment. We have total 8 kinds of pronoun and surely we are going to discuss all of them one by one. The very first is personal pronoun. A personal pronoun refers to a specific person or thing and changes its form to indicate person, number, gender and case. Like I, we, you, it, they, etc. Children, we all know that there are 3 person. First person, singular, I, plural, we. In the same way, second person, singular and plural, you. And third person, if masculine gender is there, masculine singular is there, then it is he. For feminine, we use she. Non-personal, it, plural, they. Now we will understand that how personal pronoun works as subjective case, objective case and possessive case. So there are 3 cases of pronoun: subjective, objective and possessive. Simple concept with simple examples. He saw a cat. Here he is subject of the sentence, so the pronoun he is subjective case. Mahesh met her. Here her is the object of the sentence, so the pronoun her is objective case. This book is yours. Yours is possessive case, which shows ownership or possession, so that's why it is called possessive case. Personal pronoun. In the beginning only I told you that there are three persons. First person, who are the speakers? Like I am explaining to you, so I am the speaker. Second person is you, to whom I am speaking to. And third person, spoken about. Definitely I'll be speaking about someone, something. So that is third person. Further, genders. Personal pronouns have three gender forms: masculine, feminine, and neuter. Number also, pronoun can be in singular, it can be in plural also. Now, what is the use of subjective or nominative? Subjective case is called nominative also, and objective case is called accusative also. What are the uses? Subjective or nominative pronouns are used as subject of a verb, means doer of the action. I know him, he is happy. Sometimes as complement of the verb, like to be. It is I. Was it they? It is he who has to pay the bill. Not in subjective case or in objective case, but as complement. Next point is the objective or accusative form. It is used sometimes as direct object. I saw him. I hit him. I praised him. He met me. He gave me. These all are direct object of a verb. Next we have the pronoun it. Students, it is the third person singular neuter pronoun. It is used for things and often for animals. Like the possessive form of it is its, and the plural is they and them. But there is no change in the case when subjective and objective are concerned. Look at the crow. It always. I bought this pen and gave it. Here it refers to pen. It refers to crow. The snake has entered its hole. Now possessive case is there, so obviously its will be used. Further, remember that it is used in expression of time, distance and temperature. It is very hot. It is 5 kilometers away from this place. It is 3 p.m. It is 2 p.m. It is Monday. It is 35 degrees Celsius, etc. So for time, distance and temperature also it is used. Next is, it can replace the two infinitive. Two infinitive means two plus first form of the verb. To find fault is easy. We can write in such a way, it is easy to find fault. To solve this sum is difficult. It is difficult to solve this sum. Next use is, it can replace a clause at the beginning of a sentence. That he told a lie is unfortunate. It is unfortunate that he told a lie. It also acts as subject for verbs like appear, look, seem. If such verbs are there, then also it is used in the beginning. I hope till here, students, there is no problem. Further, we have possessive pronoun. Children, possessive pronoun shows ownership. This book is mine. These notebooks are hers. These belongings are yours. Ownership. A possessive pronoun can function as a subject of a sentence. Like hers is on the table, ours is blue one, theirs will be given next week. So when possessive pronoun is used as doer of the action, then it is called the subjective case. And not only the subjective case, it can be used as possessive pronoun, means it can be used as complement also. This book is mine. Now it is not used as subject. This is yours. It is used as complement in the sentence. Possessives appear in two forms. In as determiners, like this is my book, this is her house. These two are the examples of possessive determiners. And mine, yours, his, her, ours, etc. are used independently. This book is mine, that house is hers. That is possessive pronoun which are used independently. Next type is reflexive pronoun. Always remember that pronouns are called reflexive when they have self with them, like myself, yourself, herself, himself, etc. And they are always used in the sentence after verb. They are used to refer back to the subject of a clause or sentence. He locked himself. She cut herself. He is subject and reflexive pronoun is referring back to the subject. And always remember, the formation of reflexive is that with pronoun self is added. Next, a reflexive pronoun can be used as indirect object. They had to find themselves a new house. She made herself a new dress. That is indirect object of the verb. Reflexive pronoun can be used as subject complement. If you know the subject of the sentence, then it is quite easy for you to understand what is subject complement. That poor boy was myself. Means I am referring to myself. She does not look herself. She is subject, herself, myself, subject complement. Another is, a reflexive pronoun can be used as object of a preposition. Obviously, after preposition, it will be used in the sentence. Among, about, these are prepositions. So they were quarreling among themselves. He started by talking about himself. Some verbs take a reflexive pronoun as object. We enjoyed ourselves. You should avail yourself of this chance. He adapted himself to the new situation. When as object they are used in the sentence, then that case is reflexive pronoun as object. Next is reflexive pronoun, myself, himself, etc. are sometimes used in the place of the object. Forms of personal pronoun. This happen after as, for, like, but. As for myself, I don't want to go there. For someone like me or myself, it is better to stay indoor. So if means the reflexive pronoun myself, himself, etc. are sometimes used in the place of the objective form of the personal pronoun. Next type is emphasizing or intensive pronoun. Beta, the formation is the same like self is added with such pronoun also, but the difference in reflexive and emphasizing is that much that reflexive pronoun is used after verb and emphasizing pronoun is used after noun or pronoun. The reflexive pronouns can be used to emphasize a noun or pronoun. Like here you can see the example, the chief minister himself gave the award. Here the chief minister noun is there and himself is used just after chief minister. So we can say that emphasizing pronoun is used after noun or pronoun. In the emphatic use, reflexive pronoun follow a noun or another pronoun. Next is demonstrative pronoun. In demonstrative pronoun, this, that, these, those. These four words you need to remember. This is a singular word, that is also a singular word, these and those are plural. But the difference is of people or thing in relationship to the speaker or writer in space and time, that is near or far. How can we justify this statement? This is a singular pronoun and this is used to show nearness. That is also a singular pronoun and it shows the thing, place, person far. These plural and it shows nearness. Those plural, it shows distance. Another is interrogative pronoun. In interrogative pronoun, we will have WH family members and they are used to ask questions about personal and non-personal noun. What did you buy? Which one did you buy? Who met you? Whom did you meet? These all are WH family members which are used to ask questions. Next is indefinite pronoun, quite easy. Indefinite pronoun, when we don't know the exact thing, person. An indefinite pronoun lacks the definiteness of personal reflexive and possessive or demonstrative pronoun. The meaning is always to do with quantity. Like if I say that someone is knocking at the door, I don't know who the person is. He went somewhere, I don't know which place. So that is called indefinite pronoun. And anyone, everyone, everything, somebody, something, no one, nobody, these pronouns come under indefinite pronoun. And some of these pronouns are all, both, each, much, many, more, most, etc. There are a number of indefinite pronouns. Next is relative pronoun. Obviously, relative pronoun will show some sort of link, some sort of relation between one phrase or clause to the another phrase or clause. And basically, one phrase is connected with another phrase by using who, whom, that, which, etc. They are always defined by एडजेक्टिव क्लोज और रिलेटिव क्लोज वी कॉल इट. रिलेटिव क्लोजेज आर ऑफ टू काइंड्स. वन इज डिफाइनिंग, वन इज नॉन डिफाइनिंग. इन डिफाइनिंग एंड नॉन डिफाइनिंग वी यूज हु, whom, whose, which, of which, whose, etc. means when there is person concerned, then who, whom, who, whose, these pronouns are used. If things are concerned, then which, of which, whose, that are used. And in defining only, for person and thing, only and only that is used. So this was all about the explanation of all the types of pronoun along with the definition. Children, go through with the definition and the kinds of pronoun and start doing the exercise. It is so easy to listen to the video. It is so easy to read, but practical knowledge is required, and we come to know about our understanding through exercises only. Once you will start doing exercises, then you will come to know whether the concept is clear to you or not. So till then, good day, keep practicing and take a very good care of yourself. Thank you.